What is this about? Well, first of all, I'm on a cheeky little ride to go for a swim to a secret beach. I'm going to natter at you about a few products that I've been talking about for a while, some of them related to this bike, some of them not.
Oh, it's hot. Very, very hot.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good night, wherever you are, Blue Marble Riders. It's hot. Did I tell you that? I'm on Vancouver Island, and yesterday this rock reached 42 Celsius, a record. Today, well, it's up to 38. Yesterday I rode in to get my Pfizer shot. Some of you might have seen that on Instagram, and I clocked 40, but later it was up to 42. I was fully kitted, fully geared like I am now, and it was actually cooler riding like that than riding in a t-shirt and shorts. I'm sure some of you people down in Arizona and Texas can actually confirm that. You don't actually get the beat of the sun on you. I'm going to natter at you about a few products that I've been talking about for a while, some of them related to this bike, some of them not. The first one I'm really interested in talking about is, if you take a look, it's 38. I've been riding around for quite a bit here, and I'm on 3 bars. That is fantastic. Thank you, Ivan. He richened the mixture, put the fan on sooner, and I guarantee you today you will not see this up to 5 bars in 38 Celsius. Yesterday in 42, same thing. This thing hovers between 2 if you're on the highway, 2 and 3, if you're doing a steady 60 miles an hour, 100 clicks, or if you're buzzing around town like this, 3 and 4, mainly 3. It'll go down to 3 pretty quickly after you get going again. So that is a vast improvement on what was a bike that ran a little too hot because it was lean. So for those of you who haven't done the Ivan Reflash, once again, all I can say to you is, what are you waiting for? Get on it, especially if you're down south. Oh, just some wind flow. And the second thing is, this is the bike for hot weather. My Suzuki, I can't ride it until the evening. It is just too hot behind the shield, the GV airflow, which of course says good things about the GV, or GV, however you pronounce it, because it keeps the air off you. It does such a good job that in hot climates, I'm not sure it's the shield for you. Maybe it is. Maybe you're more stoic than I am. Look at that. We've been idling for a while, still on 3. Look at that, boys. Be amazed. The helmet is another product people have been asking me about. This is a Scorpion EXO something. I'll put the link to my review up here. I'll put the name of it on the screen right here, okay? And yeah, it's been really good. A lot of people have asked me, it's been 2.5 years now, Blue Marble Rider, what is this thing like? Well, it stood up to the test of time really well, except for one thing. The wonderful KTM orange that was on it, I don't have a KTM, but every KTM owner I see said, what helmet is that? I want it! Has turned a sort of salmon pink. Not really, it's still orange, but there's definitely a salmon pink glow, which means to me that perhaps that's a quality control issue that Scorpion could take care of. But other than that, this helmet's been magnificent. Yes, it's polycarb, but that does mean that it changes or disperses the loads better, in my opinion, than some carbon helmets do. They tend to crack in one spot, although I would love a carbon helmet, don't get me wrong. The other thing people complain about this helmet is the noise level, and they'll say it's quite high. It is, but you know what? If you've seen my video about me being a scallywag when I was younger on a motorbike, I never rode with earplugs, and I have, because of that, folks, I have a little bit of tinnitus or tinnitus, depending on how you say it. And yeah, in my left ear, I've got a sort of a slight high-pitched whine, and believe it or not, it's a bit like Peter Pan's alligator or crocodile. I've got a bit of a ticking sound. All of that, I think, from motorcycle riding in high wind noises. I mean, when you're on a naked bike or a near naked bike like this, you're going to get a lot of wind roar, so I wear earplugs now. So, of course, the volume thing for me is not an issue because I just don't really hear it. So buying a shoe berth wouldn't make any sense because this is as quiet right now as a shoe berth. Quieter, I bet, with my earplugs in. And just take note, boys, still 3 bars, here I am, and what is it, 35 Celsius now. Oh, getting cooler, but I tell you, like I said, I've been riding in the 42s and it's been spectacular. Got a little bit of criticism the other day when I talked about my top 5 dislikes for this bike. People took it way too seriously. I did say at the beginning I love the bike, But some people, I don't know what it is, brand loyalty, or they take it very, very personally anyway. One guy was a little bit naughty and about the fact my speedo doesn't go up very much when I'm riding. Well, it doesn't on camera, chap. I'll tell you why. Well, I think you probably figure that out. It's that if it does go up high and someone from the police station sees it, they can pull me in. And I've got enough videos with my plate in the background that it wouldn't be a hard job for them. So, no, I don't tend to ride over the speed limit when I'm on camera. And if I do, it's very conservative. Nothing more than most of the other traffic. It just isn't an advert I want to put out there for two reasons. One, I don't want to get busted. And two, I don't think it's a good idea to do it all the time anyway. I don't want to promote riding recklessly. I did that in my youth. I don't do it anymore. I get fun out of just riding. And yeah, there are times I go fast, but you know, they're private. And I'm not going to talk about them or big that up at all, because it's really not something I want to discuss. I can't remember your name, but I hope that makes sense to you. Judging by your language, and it wasn't impolite, but the turn of phrase you use, like we, I'm guessing you were probably Scottish. And if you were, my commiserations to being beaten by Croatia. Certainly gave England a good game, although I don't think England performed very well in that match. But I have to say, we've just beaten Germany 2-0. I'm elated, ecstatic. It wasn't the prettiest, but I think it was a good enough game. And I think we deserve the victory. Oh, getting closer to the lovely beach. This is a nasty corner. There we go. Yeah, it's getting closer. Now the tide is super low right now. It's going to be a little bit of work for me. And lastly, before I leave you, I'd like to thank you. Over the past year or so, I've added ads to the channel, and I know it's a pain, but it's a necessary evil for me. I don't want to do Patreon. I'm not into that. But it has generated me some revenue, albeit not as much revenue as I needed for my latest purchase. And so for the next few months, contingent on you continuing to watch my channel, I will hopefully be paying my overdraft off in my YouTube account fund. But I bought a little something for the channel, which I think will really, really add another dimension to it. It was extremely expensive, not least because the company put it up 35% about a week before I bought it. I've been looking at this thing for 2 years, and the week before I spring for it, it goes up 35% unannounced. Isn't that life, eh? So anyway, that 35% accounts for about, a fair chunk of change, enough that I'll be paying it off till November. So I haven't actually got it out yet, because it tells me not to use it in temperatures over 40 Celsius, which is the other really annoying side of the purchase, is that I just get this thing, pay more for it, and then of course the temperature goes AWOL on us. Hopefully the first you'll know about it is some nice tweaks to the channel. And just to continue watching me, I really thank you for that. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that little bell. Click the little bell in the that corner right up there. You'll get notifications every time I release a video. Now apologies too, my video releasing has been a bit scant lately, and it's going to be a bit scant for the next 2 or 3 weeks as I take what I would consider a hard-earned holiday. I've been working my buns off at work and then coming home and building a deck in this heat, and I am going to take some time off and go and sit by the water, on the water, sail in the water, and relax for a couple of weeks. I hope to get some vids out. And just thank you for continuing to subscribe, continuing to watch for you regular viewers, and the nice feedback you give me. I really appreciate it. Anyway, thanks very much. This is the Blue Marble Rider out. You didn't really think I was going to take you to my secret beach, did you? There's enough people moving here. I can't do that. Thanks for watching. Nice legs, sir. Could you wear longer shorts, though?
Once again, thanks for watching, everyone. If this is the first time you've watched, please consider subscribing. I do product reviews, motorcycle reviews, off-road and on-road vlogs, as well as tours. Don't forget to follow me on social media, that's Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter, and to like, and especially, I'm begging you here, folks, subscribe. This is the Blue Marble Rider, out.